Hello, everyone. Welcome to the third week of this course on the circular economy. Last week, we looked at value creation in a circular economy and how this can be beneficial for companies. We discussed the case of RiverSimple and described the linear economy. In the forum, we saw interesting examples of acquisition. For instance, the vending machines in Istanbul that allow you to trade recyclable bottles for public transportation credits, and a large Canadian bulk food retailer where you get a 15% discount when you bring your own container to fill certain food with. For the case of RiverSimple, most of you argued it's a use-oriented model, as a consumer pays to use a car for a certain time. Some of you also considered a result-oriented model, as RiverSimple takes care of many extra services. There is not always a clear distinction. We can see aspects from both in this business model. It has also become clear that you understand the up and downside of following a linear economy and what it takes to switch over to a circular model. This is what this course is about. We are happy to see the new and interesting discussions on this topic. This week, we will start learning about the value of longer-lasting products. Making products that last is a key feature of the circular economy. This episode is going to be active and hands-on. We'll see how leading innovators at Fairphone have rewritten the rules on how phones go together and come apart again. We then invite you to take apart a product yourself in order to learn how it was put together and to consider its repairability. Have fun!